When I first became sexually active, one of the things that scared me the most about having sex was herpes. If only I had known then what I know now, I probably wouldn't have been quite as terrified. Well, hi babes. I'm sorry I haven't uploaded in a little while. June was a really shitty month, so I thought, what better way to kick things back off than with herpes? There are actually 8 different types of herpes. That includes Epstein-Barr, aka mono, BZV, aka chickenpox, and of course, herpes simplex virus 1 and 2, the ones that I'm gonna be talking about today. HSV-1 typically appears on your mouth, whereas HSV-2 appears on the genitals. A lot more people have type 1, which is fortunate because it tends to be less aggressive than type 2. How do you get it? You can get herpes from literally any sexual contact. Oral sex, you can transmit it from your mouth to someone's genitals. Vaginal sex, anal sex, even just dry humping, rubbing. All it takes is contact with an active infection and some friction. The plot twist is that a lot of people don't know they have an active infection because there aren't any symptoms. So yes, you can still get herpes even if you thoroughly visually inspect someone's genitals before having sex. Condoms and dental dams will lower your risk, but there's no way to completely eliminate the possibility of herpes. You can get tested with your partner beforehand, but herpes screening is not usually considered part of normal STI screening, mostly because herpes very rarely causes health complications. Notably, you do not get herpes from hot tubs, toilet seats, doorknobs. I don't know why you'd be rubbing your genitals on a doorknob. I'm not one to judge. That said, there's a little teeny tiny chance that herpes could survive for a very short amount of time on wet towels as well as sex toys. FYI. So what does herpes actually look like? And this is where sex ed typically fails everyone. They'll show you like a super pussy, bubbly mess. Yes, some people have bad outbreaks. Outbreaks usually include a few little blisters that pop up, eventually break, and then take a few weeks to heal. Bad outbreaks can be pretty painful, but for most people, it's actually relatively mild, maybe a little redness, some bumps, it might look like an insect bite. Herpes can hang out around the anus, the labia, the penis, but also in places that you can't see, like inside your pee hole or the cervix. That's in the vagina. The first outbreak is usually the worst. Over time, outbreaks will get milder as your immune system gets accustomed to it. Herpes is a viral STI, which means that there is no cure, but there is treatment. Antiviral medications are very effective at suppressing the virus. This will help you control outbreaks and also make sure that you don't pass it on to a partner. There are also 3 vaccines that are being studied to prevent herpes in the first place. Now, if you're worried that you might have herpes, please do not self-diagnose. I freaked myself out so many times when I was younger thinking I had herpes and it was just, you know, razor burn, stupid shit. You definitely want to go to a doctor for a diagnosis. You might do a physical test, which is actually the least accurate, or a swab test or a blood test. This will confirm that you had herpes and which strain it is. What's the worst part of having herpes? It could be painful and itchy sometimes, but there's antivirals for that. If you get pregnant, you'll have to make sure that you talk to your doctor to make sure you don't transmit it to your baby, but that can be done too. For most people, the worst part of herpes isn't any of these things. It's the social stigma of it. A positive herpes diagnosis can feel devastating, like it's the end of the world, your life will never be the same, your relationships will never be the same. The truth is, herpes is not dangerous, it's completely manageable, and your life will go back to normal. Herpes stigma in society is the direct result of sexuality being taboo and shameful. Think about it. People think that herpes on your mouth is different than herpes on your genitals. They're the same exact virus. The only difference is that one is more explicitly tied to sex than the other. Fairly recently, people didn't really see herpes as a big deal. It wasn't until antivirals hit the market that language around herpes became much more negative and stigmatizing. After all, it sold drugs. I think we all need to do our part to fight the stigma, because we as a society do more damage to people who have herpes than the actual herpes virus itself. That's a problem. So if you get a positive diagnosis, gotta start checking that stigma first. Another thing that's gonna change, you'll have to tell new partners about it first. I'm gonna put some resources down below about how to have that conversation. Long story short is that yes, it might seem awkward and uncomfortable, particularly at first, but it's gonna get easier and it's gonna make you a way better communicator about sex. This is stuff people should be talking about anyway. Another part of life after herpes is management. So that might mean antiviral drugs, it might mean keeping track of your outbreaks, all things to reduce your outbreaks and to reduce transmission. prevention. Lastly, it may be helpful to see a counselor to help you in processing this. Like I said, the mental health effects are often far worse for people than the physical effects, so take care of yourself. When you're going through some struggles, a counselor can be there to remind you, this is a part of life. A lot of people go through this. Let's manage this in a healthy way. Okay, my dears, that's the one-on-one. If you have thoughts or stories to share, please post them down below. Love y'all. I'll see you next time. Mwah.
Except your mom. Oh.
What?